So this is cute, very, very nice.
Hi, guys.
I like this. What a cute place. That'll be nice for kids.
Yeah, our neighborhood is actually pretty awesome.
What do you think about Pat inviting us over?
I'm in.
What I'm seeing is that we're all gonna gang up on Jeff.
I think so.
How long have you been here? Give me some stats on the house.
We bought this house actually at the beginning of our relationship. This was supposed to be like our 5-year house.
Yeah.
Cut to 17 and a half years later, two kids, a couple dogs, you know.
Have you guys done anything to the house?
I mean, we've painted a bunch of different colors all throughout the house. I like color.
Shame, shame.
And then we did update, like, years ago, the floor downstairs is a heated tile floor.
Oh, okay.
And then we did a little teeny, like, splash to our fireplace a year ago.
What is the bedroom, bathroom count of the house?
3-bedroom, 2.5 bath.
We listed it at 420. We put it on the market a couple times.
Okay.
It just didn't really sell. Now's the time, though, because we know that our dream house is going to be coming on the market that we really, really love, but we got to sell it. So before we do that, it just needs to be updated. But you know Jeff.
Yeah. So. Well, we do keep him pretty busy.
Yes.
But we can definitely also push him.
Can we take a look inside?
Yeah.
All right.
Awesome. Come on in.
I actually really enjoy when we work with people that we know.
Yeah.
Because it kind of brings a little more
sentimentalness. Sentimentally.
Oh!
And the first problem area is.
Unfortunately, there are buyers out there where they're like, okay, I want to live in this area at this price point with these bed and bath count, but not a split level. So we have to remove that obstacle.
We think this house is most likely going to attract first-time buyers or possibly rental property investors. So we want to de-emphasize the split level in the entryway. We'll knock down the wall adjacent to the stairs to make the area more breathable. Then add a window door to bring in more light and create an overall more inviting ambiance right when the buyers walk through the door. In your kitchen, we want to create more sight lines to the rest of the house, so we'll lose the dividing wall, and as much as it pains us, the fireplace, to create a spacious open flow. That way, the kitchen becomes a centerpiece to the house and hub for families, which is something that buyers with kids will love.
Then this is the main. Oh, this is actually nice size.
And not a nursery.
I mean, I like blue.
Yeah.
Okay, now I'm seeing Pat. Your struggle. Yeah.
Your struggle with all the color.
Your struggle's real, dude.
Yeah. Holy crap! What? That is literally the brightest room I've ever seen.
I wanted a happy color to wake me up in the
okay,
morning.
That's not happy, that's disturbing.
I'm actually really concerned about you.
For your main bath, we'd want to diminish the awkward use of space by putting in a larger countertop. We'll make Jeff figure out how to do that. We also want to capitalize on your walk-in shower by adding a subway tile design, and then we'll give the whole bathroom a whole new life with a fresh coat of neutral paint.
Let's see downstairs.
I'm seeing black spots.
Yes.
Oh, this is nice.
Yeah.
Did you guys put up this wall?
We did.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, I like this. This is a nice bar.
That's actually a wedding gift from my brother to us when we got married.
Oh. So these are the floors that you're talking about are heated.
Correct.
This space is awesome. I mean, I could see buyers honestly using this a ton of different ways. This is a great size room.
Buyers will salivate over a house that has a place to play with their kids in the day and enjoy a cocktail together in the cozy evening warmth. So for your downstairs area, we want to accentuate the unique features of the bar and the heated tiles. We'll knock down the wall, paint with a lighter color, and reimagine it as a lounge.
So what do you think of all of that?
I think it would be amazing, honestly.
Well, let's talk numbers. With, you know, the kitchen, that main bathroom, pause for dramatic effect with that paint.
And then transforming the downstairs area into a lounge.
And even opening up to give more light to the entryway, we kind of feel if it's a $40,000 project, you know, Jeff will kind of throw us a couple bones and make this work around $30,000. For homes in this area that have those remodels, I mean, our comps are coming in, you know, closer to probably about $500,000. You were trying to sell it for $20,000, so that would allow us to list the home at $500,000. So if we were at 420 originally, we put in 30,000 and we list at 500. Once we get our $30,000 back, that's an additional $50,000 on top of where we were.
Which we would split 25,000 and 25,000.
So that's a huge increase.
We don't care what it costs, we just have to get this house sold.
While Leslie and I have been scheming on how to get Gina and Pat top dollar with our design, Jeff and his crew have been busy gutting the kitchen, knocking down the living room wall, taking out the stair railing, and demoing the bathroom so that we can start putting our plan into action.
Jeff, I come bearing gifts.
Oh, wow.
Oh my gosh.
You have done a lot.
We just have a lot on our list to just kind of nitpick through and make decisions on.
So we are coming to talk about solving a few problems in our design,
starting with how to get more space into that tiny, blindingly yellow main bathroom.
Can you guys explain to me what's going on here with this bathroom?
The main bath was so tiny, so I'm gonna extend the main bath out.
I actually love that because the main bath was one of our biggest challenges.
And we know how you felt about the color.
Literally, just seeing it right now is giving me flashbacks. Yeah. Am I standing in the shower?
You are.
Oh, okay.
The new shower. So I'm able to put in like a complete 3x4 shower.
That's amazing. Awesome.
Which is a really good size.
So this will be tiled on the sides, tiled on the back wall, and then we will paint.
Yeah, it's gonna be gorgeous.
It will be great. Now, speaking of tile,
let's go check out the tile that we brought. So I just brought some of the extras that I know and, you know, that we have left over from jobs that we've done with you.
We have boxes.
We have to mix them.
Well that's what we may have to do. These we could maybe use in the bathroom.
So you can do something like this, and then you can take and do like a larger band.
Oh.
So, I mean, we can
mix
and match different sizes and stuff like that if it's done correctly.
Yeah. Okay, so we can pull what you have, pull what we have, do this in the bathrooms. So I'm thinking something like this for the kitchen.
So I need guidance on the kitchen.
Okay, let's do it.
So excited! Control the excitement, Pat.
Do my best.
Are you nervous?
I'm nervous, yes.
You are?
Yes.
I'm excited. Okay. I'm super excited.
Me too.
Okay,
here we go.
Look at this.
Whoa.
This is not our house.
It is. I've got you.
It looks so much bigger.
I just need to sit down for a minute.
Oh, for sure. I was thinking of like French country. I wanted that really kind of open, romantic kind of feel with the railing. We went for like that country fence look. And we just wanted to go with something that people could just picture themselves in.
This is just beautiful.
Yay.
Sorry.
No, I love that you love it.
You can tell that you guys added a little extra love in there and like, I mean.
We did, yeah.
I never knew what to do with that wall.
Yeah, so the board and batten was immediately something that you just went, you know, and your eyes went straight up.
I don't know if you were aware, but that's one of my favorite brick tiles.
No!
You guys said one of the biggest struggles here was the size of the kitchen.
Yeah. And I can't.
Yeah, you can't touch. It's like a chain now.
Yes. But it's not so far that you feel disconnected.
No, not at all. And that hood.
Yeah. Yeah, your brother did a phenomenal job.
Want to go get some lunch, dinner?
Yes.
Actually, it's probably more dinner at this point.
I don't
care
what they call it. I'm hungry.
I know, me too.
So.
Well, Lindsay's supposed to come meet us and...
Soon?
I would imagine. I'm looking at my fake watch. Anyways, hey, did you hear that we sold Gina's?
I did.
We listed it at $500,000.
Okay.
And we ended up selling it $540,000.
What?
I know. We had four or five offers and went under contract in 3 days.
That's great.
I know.
How is she? She's
happy.
Oh,
she's thrilled.